Hello friends, based on the law of conservation of linear momentum, our attempt was to find out the velocity with which the rocket is launching or the rocket is moving. Now in the previous section we have seen that final velocity of the rocket to be achievable is equal to minus u times log m to the base e plus c, where v is the velocity to be achieved, u is the velocity with which the escaping gases move, and m is the mass of the instantaneous mass of the rocket, c is the constant of integration. You can get rid of this constant of integration by applying boundary conditions. Suppose before launching, that is when t equal to 0, entire rocket is at rest, v equal to 0, and the total mass of the rocket, instantaneous mass of the rocket, becomes m naught, initial mass. If you substitute these boundary conditions, then you see that c is equal to u times log m naught to the base e. Therefore, in this particular equation, if you replace c, ultimately you have velocity v equal to minus u times log m to the base e and u times log m naught to the base e. If you club the terms, then v equal to u times log m naught by m to the base e. Here m naught is the initial mass of the system, which is made up of two parts, mass of the rocket plus mass of the fuel. Therefore, the equation comes out to be u equal to log to the base e mf plus mr divided by mr. In another form, the same equation can be written as v or v maximum equal to u times log 1 plus mf by mr to the base e. So this is the equation which gives the velocity of the rocket. Now let us substitute certain values for u, mf and mr so that we can see what is the velocity which is achievable in the equation. Now let us see, if you look at the equation, the velocity of the rocket depends on u, the initial velocity, initial velocity of the gas which are escaping, mass of the fuel, mass of the rocket. Now velocity of exhaust, mass of the rocket and fuel, these are the three factors that change the velocity of the rocket. But for everything there is a limit. Now normally the limit for the velocity of escape or velocity u depends on the nozzle design, and maximum one can achieve u as 2 km per second. Similarly, maximum value of the ratio between mx by mr, mf by mr, can be 9. You cannot have more than this. Therefore, if you estimate v maximum equal to 2 into 10 to the power 3 log to the base e 1 plus 9, or it comes out to be velocity achievable is v maximum equal to 2 into 10 to the power 3 into 2.303 times log 10 to the base 10. If you simplify this particular equation, the velocity comes out to be 4.6 km per second. So velocity of the rocket is 4.6 km per second. Now you can ask one question. Whenever such a rocket is launched with such a low velocity, 4.6 km per second, whether the rocket moves up and whether it goes to the destination, that question arises. Normally all of us know escape velocity of the Earth or orbital velocity of the Earth is very much larger than this 4.6. Therefore, if the rocket is launched with our design with 4.6 km per second, you cannot achieve the particular, you cannot launch the rocket or you cannot launch the satellite. Therefore, the initial velocity is to be enhanced. So for this purpose, what is done is multi-stage rockets are used. As all of us know, the value obtained here is very much less than escape velocity of the Earth, 11 km per second. Therefore, if you want to launch any object or launch a rocket, it should escape from the Earth's atmosphere. The minimum velocity should be 11 km per second. Therefore, how to get the velocity nearly 11 km per second? To achieve this, multi-stage rockets are used. Now, the concept of multi-stage rocket is that the different stages will be there in the rocket. Initially, first stage is fired and entire fuel in the first stage is burnt, and the velocity which is achieved at the end of the first stage is given as initial velocity to the second stage. So this is how gradually the velocity of the rocket goes on increasing. Now let us see what about the different parts of the rocket. In different sections, in the first stage is heavy and large, and the second stage is light and small. Now under launching, first stage burns first and gets delinked from the assembly, and the second stage starts with the initial velocity gained by the first stage. Therefore, velocity of the second stage is greater than the first stage, and it is possible to attain required velocity. So here the concept is, first stage velocity you get it as nearly 4.6 kilometers per second. This velocity is given as the initial velocity to the second stage, and second stage will have larger velocity by the factor 4.6. This is how in multi-stage rockets velocity goes on increasing, and ultimately that will be more than the escape velocity, and definitely one can launch a rocket or any satellite in the space. So this is the basic principle behind the launching of a rocket. Now let us take a lively example. Let us take a problem just to understand the concept. See, the problem reads like this. An empty rocket weighs 5000 kilogram and it contains 45,000 kg of the fuel. If the exhaust velocity of the escaping gas is 2 km per second, we are supposed to find out maximum velocity achieved or attained. So the formula here used is V maximum equal to U log 1 plus MF by MR. So here the given values are MF, mass of the fuel is given 45,000 kilograms, and M naught, mass of MR, mass of the rocket is given 5,000 kilograms, and escape velocity of the gas U is given 2 kilometers per second. Therefore, if you substitute in this particular formula, it comes out to be 2 into 10 to the power 3 log E to the base E 1 plus 45,000 divided by 5,000. So next step is you have to convert that to the base E to the base 10. So you have to multiply it by 2.303. So the equation comes out to be 2 into 10 to the power 3 into 2.303 log 10 to the base 10. Log 10 to the base 10 is 1. Therefore, the entire equation boils down to 4.6 kilometer per second. So for this formula, velocity achieved by the rocket is 4.6 kilometers per second. So this velocity is very much less than the escape velocity. Therefore, with this value, this data, or with this design, you cannot launch any rocket. For that, multi-stage rockets are used. In the multi-stage rockets, as I already told you, different stages are getting detached and the entire system becomes lighter and lighter. To keep the momentum constant, velocity goes on increasing, and ultimately that velocity reaches the escape velocity of the Earth. And this is how one can achieve the escape velocity, and one will succeed in putting the satellite in the orbit or launching the vehicle or launching the rocket. Thank you.